the earth fault loop impedance path of an installation connected to a TNS earthing arrangement. In the event of there being a fault between the line conductor in the installation and an exposed conductive part, the fault path or earth fault path would be as followed. The exposed conductive part would become live. This is connected to the circuit protective conductor, the CPC. This would become live. This goes back to the earth terminal situated within the consumer unit, which would become live. This is connected to the incoming earthing conductor, which comes in with the meter tails. This earthing conductor becomes live. The earthing conductor is connected to the lead or steel sheath of the supply authority's cable, which becomes live. This is connected to the earth neutral point within the transformer, which becomes live, back round the line conductor, completing the circuit. The fault current will pass through the main cutout fuse, rated at either 100, 80 or 60 amps, but will not cause operation. The fuse that will operate is the one closest to the fault. In this case, the fuse located within the consumer unit will operate, clearing the fault in circuit. This is the full earth fault loop path and needs to be a very low impedance in order to generate a very high fault current to cause rapid operation of the overcurrent protection device. We looked at two maximum times for disconnection, either a maximum time of 5 seconds or a maximum time of 0.4. I have described to you the earth fault loop path for an installation connected to a TNS earthing arrangement. Total earth fault loop impedance, ZS, is measured at the furthest point of a radial circuit and comprises of the impedance offered by the line conductor, R1, the impedance offered by the circuit protective conductor, R2, and the impedance offered by the supply authority's cable. The maximum impedance of the supply authority's cable depends on the earthing arrangement. The drawing shown here is a TNS earthing arrangement. The supply authority's maximum impedance of that cable, ZE, is 0.8 of an ohm. The total earth fault loop impedance of a circuit measured in ohms is found by ZS, being the total earth fault loop impedance, equals ZE, the supply authority's cable's impedance, added to R1, the line conductor's impedance, added to R2, the circuit protective conductor's impedance. The formula is ZS equals ZE plus R1 plus R2. This drawing shows a TNCS earthing arrangement, and the supply authority's cable now has a maximum external impedance, ZE, of 0.35 of an ohm. Total circuit impedance, ZS, is still ZS equals ZE plus R1 plus R2.